Hey guys, welcome back. In this video, we're going to fix this battery. I assume there is one dead cell in it, so I am going to see, can I replace just one cell, and how cheaply can we do it? It's fully charged just off the charger. I give it a spin. It's turning very slowly. So even when I grab the chuck to give it some drag or some load, it's just not able for it because there's just not enough power in the battery. So in this video, we're going to fix the battery as cheap as we can. So the first job is to separate the battery from the drill. Okay, we're not going to need the drill for a long time, so let's look at the battery. Okay, so there's this little safety cover in the holes just here, and just an ordinary pick will just get it out. And then there's three little screws, 1, 2, 3, and I'm about to undo the fourth screw just here, and it's just a normal screwdriver just undoes them. Okay, now we can separate it, and this is our cells. So there's, each of these are about 4.2 volts, I think, and then they discharge down to 3.2 or something like that. So they should be around 3 or 4 volts, and this is freshly charged off the charger, so it should be fairly high. So let's check each one of these cells. Okay, to test each one of these cells, it's just my multimeter. I have it in DC volts. So now I'm going to check each one of these cells by putting the prongs onto left and right and check them the whole way down. Okay, just because I am making a video and I'm doing this one-handed, this one here is common, so I can just jam the negative into both sides here, and then we're going to read off our voltages. So we're going to just put the prong on here. 3.8, okay. Okay, now we can go on to the next cell. Yeah. Okay, now onto the next cell, which is these two here are common behind here. So there's an isolator, so we can go in there, and now we can put the negative onto this cell here. Are we testing both of these? Okay, that cell is okay. On to the next one. That cell here is okay. Okay, so let's try the last one. Okay, so that's actually touching the end of this cell here. So we're gonna touch this one and see what it is. Oh, here we go, look, 0.66. Nearly 666, the mark, there we go, the mark of the beast. So it's zero, so there is actually a point or a decimal point just there. So that is the dead cell, so this one here. Okay, so these are the cells left over from my previous other battery when I swapped all of the cells. So we're just going to see if any of these cells are any good. So here's the first one. I think I have 5 of them anyway to check. So you can see the voltage just there. There's nothing in that one. So I wonder, was that one marked? Oh, it was. Okay. Let's try the next cell. Okay, 4 volts. Okay. I'm going to attempt to install this one in where the dead cell is in this pack here. Okay, just marked it just there, so that's the dead one, and we're going to remove it. So the way we're going to remove it is literally use a screwdriver and just hopefully, if we can, might even use the pick. We're going to try and just pry off these little bars just here and this one here, and then we'll have to solder them afterwards because I don't have a spot welder. Okay, so I just got one side off just there now, and just using the screwdriver and just working it off. There you go, that's 2 off. Now do these 2. Okay, so just work the screwdriver in there. 1, 2. Okay, now with that removed, I can just bend them back slightly, just out of the way. And now we should be able, let me just tear that off. That's glue on one side, glue on the other side. Now we should be able just to pull that cell out. Now, first of all, so there's a little line or a little dimple, you'll see it just there. So we get our good cell and literally straight away put it back in because there's no point mixing them up. So actually, the writing is actually the same way around. So that's the 2 cells. And the writing, they're both 18650s, which is great. Now we're just going to install that there now. Okay, That's actually probably some of the hardest job done. So what we're going to do now is start the soldering iron, because I've no way of actually spot welding them. And we're literally just going, we're going to tin the little arms here and then very quickly try and solder them together and not put too much heat in the battery, because if you put too much heat in the battery, it's done. It's dead. There's nothing you can do about it. So we're just going to see if this works. It's a really cheap fix, so why not try it? Okay, so what we're going to do is actually just test if the cell is even working. So I have the negative and positive prongs of the multimeter into these prongs here. Now we're just going to test it, and obviously like it's just hunting there because these are still not connected. So I'm just going to squeeze them together with my fingers. And we have 20 volts, which is, these are 18 volt batteries, but when they're fully charged, they will be a little bit higher, so they will be 20. So it is actually correct. So this is going to work. Okay, and unfortunately this cell here is dead, so it can join the other pile of sick batteries. Yeah. Okay, so let's join this together and we'll solder it all up and I'll come back to you then. Okay, so not my best soldering job in the world, but it is now all soldered. So I'm going to now reset it all back in and then stick it back together and we'll test it then. Okay, that's it now all together. So I have the four greens and the one dark green or magenta blue, whatever color it is. And now we're going to get the lid on. I know my soldering job isn't the best, and probably the right way to do it is, of course, to use a spot welder. But when you don't have a spot welder, you have to make do. Okay, let's get this back together again. So that's my battery now already built. Slide it in and give it a pull. Okay, that's a lot faster already, and I'm just about to hold it. I think I just got this one. Oh! Shit, that's hot. So I got burnt there. Got a friction burn. Okay, so that's definitely fixed. So that is a super cheap fix. So for pretty much nothing, or the price of one battery, which is probably about 2 or 3 euros, I replaced a 30 euro battery. Okay, so that's it now, all built and fixed again. And we've just after testing it. And yeah, so that's a super, super cheap fix. So for only, what, probably a euro or 2 euros, just replacing one cell, obviously the bad cell, we have replaced this battery. So this battery is now fixed and working again. Brilliant. So what have I learned from doing this? So obviously very cheap to replace just one battery. And once you figure out what it is, it's very easy to replace. A spot welder would obviously be so much more easier and quicker to do. Obviously, but this isn't my daily job, so I don't really see the need for a spot welder. And yes, you should have each of the cells balanced. I don't have the cells balanced. I did measure the voltage on each of them, and obviously now I'm going to charge it, or maybe I'll just discharge it first and then recharge it, and hopefully then they'll all come up to an equal value. Obviously one is probably a little bit older than the rest of the batteries, so there is that against it, and they're probably made at different times. But overall, it is balanced. It's only a small little battery anyway. It's only used the odd time for the drills. They're not like in continuous use, but it is very handy to have that as your easy fix. So if you like this video, give me a thumbs up, hit subscribe over there, leave a comment down below. What did I do right? What did I do wrong? What do you think of the project? Would you do the same? What do you think how easy it is to fix one of these batteries? I know you can just buy a whole new battery, but that was not what the video was all about. It was to show how to actually replace just one cell within the battery and you have a working drill again. Super easy, maybe not for everyone, but it is an easy fix. So give it a thumbs up, subscribe, comment down below. As always, thanks for watching. See you next time.